season's greetings from the Glen, and welcome to Hamish and Dougal's Hogmanay Special.
Hamish.
Dougal! You'll have had your tea.
But look here, I've brought you a wee treat. The last of the turkey leftovers.
Oh, just the beak, then.
Well, you know, that'll go down very well with a few chips and a sirloin steak. Now put away that oxyacetylene torch and selection of lizards. You can finish your entry for the Turner Prize some other time.
Oh, you know, I'm still bitter about last year. If only the wind had been in the right direction.
Well, it didn't help when the breeze lifted your kilt and you shouted, "How's that for an installation?"
I know. I'm my own worst enemy.
No, I think you'll find that's Big Tam at the abattoir. Now, get a move on. The Laird wants to see us up at the Big Hoose.
On New Year's Eve? Whatever for?
He wouldn't say. But he hinted that he had a proposition to make.
He made one of those to me once.
Mrs. Naughtie, what are you doing round the back?
That's just what the Laird said.
We'd best be on our way.
Well, be sure to wrap up warm. The snow's 3 feet deep, and it's cold enough to freeze the bells off a brass monkey. With bells on it.
Don't you worry. I have thought to bring a pair of all-weather sporrans. Come along, let us strike out through the snow. Hamish, hurry up there and stop playing with that brass monkey.
Oh, the bells have fallen off.
Oh, never mind. We're here at the Big Hoose. I'll ring the bell.
That's fallen off as well.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Don't just stand there shivering. Go away.
And who might you be?
I might be Jerry Halliwell. But in fact, I'm his lairdship's butler, Lyttelton.
Lyttelton, who's that at the door?
It's me, sir.
Well, come in, for goodness sake.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, jings. We're never going to get in to hear about the Laird's golf competition and meet Tim Brooke-Taylor at this rate.
Dougal? Do you know something I don't?
I've said too much. Hamish, knock on the door.
Very well. Now, what's all this about the Laird?
Hamish Dougal. Just wait there while I ring for the butler to let you in. It's fallen off, sorry.
Oh, for goodness sake. Hey, let us in!
Let us in!
Hey!
Oi!
Yes?
Who is it, Lyttelton? Is it the Bellmanders?
No, sir. It's those two oiks with the brass monkey again.
Has the monkey any bells on it?
Not as far as I can see, sir.
That's no use to me. And shut that door. There's a terrible draught.
Certainly, sir.
Oh! What are we going to do now?
I don't know. I just don't know. But look on the bright side. We're inside the Big Hoose.
Hamish Dougal, delighted to see you. Just step outside and I'll get Lyttelton to let you in.
Thank you very much.
Oh, no. We're not falling for that one again. We'll go outside and you let us in.
Very well.
Hamish.
Yes? Oh! What?
Look out.
Oh! What was that for?
To attract your attention.
Mrs. Naughtie, what are you doing here?
The Laird has asked me to be hostess at his reception tonight.
Ah, hence the scarlet basque and the fishnet stockings.
Yes, so let's get inside, for goodness sake. This basque had bells on it when I left home.
Ah, Mrs. Naughtie, do come in.
Hamish, put your foot in the door. Well, at least we're in.
Hamish Dougal, Mrs. Naughtie, so glad you're here. I'd like you to meet my special house guest. Come in, Tim.
Hello, everyone. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, that's all right. It's a little sound effect I have to make my guests feel welcome.
Wait a minute. I know you.
Well, hello. Your lordship, you never told me Nicole Kidman was staying here.
Oh, you and your silver-tongued bullshit. Tim Brooke-Taylor.
Guilty as charged.
Aye, that round of applause confused me for a moment.
Oh, Mr. Tim, I've always admired your musicals.
I think you've got your Tims in a twist. Rice is the name you're looking for.
So you're Annika?
No, that's a Jewish holiday.
No. Oh, no, that was the woman with the big bottom who jumped out of helicopters.
And wrote Cats.
Yes.
No, in any case, Tim Rice had nothing to do with Cats.
I sympathise. Mrs. Noctis Pussy has often brought me out in a rash.
Now, I expect you're all busy getting ready for Hogmanay.
Oh, we never celebrate Hogmanay.
No, we do not. It clashes with New Year's Eve.
We have our own celebrations in the Glen. Oh, Dougal, do you remember last year at the Sporran Polisher's dinner?
How could I forget? We had the loyal toast, marmalade or honey for choice. And then...
And then...
I'm agog.
Oh, is that like the Masons?
I've said too much. Do go on, Hamish.
The haggis was brought in.
Aye.
Preceded by one of the red hot chili pipers. And someone shouted... Look at the moon.
Oh, Big Tam up to his old tricks. I wish he wouldn't do that.
Ah, here's Lyttelton with a tray of sherry. Or would you prefer a glass?
Oh, no, that's just fine.
Fortunately, we brought our own straws.
Now, Mrs. Naughtie, have you got the canapes?
The village supermarket didn't have any, so I got a can of beans instead.
Not to worry. Lyttelton, warm the spoons.
Your lordship, I had an inkling that Mrs. Naughtie might let us down with the canapes, so I took the liberty of eating earlier.
Who can that be?
Whoever it is, they brought their own doorbell. Hamish, away and let them in.
No, no, I've got a butler for that sort of thing. Lyttelton?
Sir?
Tell Hamish to let them in.
Don't worry, I'm there.
Hello, filthy knight.
Oh, now there's an offer I can't refuse.
Is that you?
No, it's me with a frisky woman.
Hamish, this is Sandy Wedge, captain of the All England Ladies Golf Cooperative.
Oh, do come in.
Thank you.
Oh! Mind your head.
Oh, too late. Story of my life. It's not much fun being 7 foot tall.
You're a fine figure of a woman.
Aye, a fine figure of two women.
Come over here and meet everybody. Mind the chandelier.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, don't apologise. It suits you.
Hello, everybody. Any of you lot play golf?
I play around now and again.
Anybody? No, let it pass.
I'll have you know, last year I was entered in the Open.
Are you a pro?
Hostess.
Oh. Sorry, the fishnet stockings misled me.
But Dougal, have you never played golf?
No, your lordship. I like women.
Well. I used to play golf. I had my club.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.